Christine Medine. I'm currently a junior at Purdue University studying dietetics and nutrition. Today I'm representing IEFRN, which is the Indiana's Emergency Food Resource Network. And today we're going to start off by incorporating avocados into quick, easy, and simple recipes. So I have a few laid out for you guys today. So our first recipe today is going to have baked falafel with avocado, and on the side it's going to have avocado hummus. So first I'm going to lay out the falafel recipe. So we're going to begin by obtaining a food processor. Our next step is 1/4 of an avocado, specifically a Haas or California avocado. You can differentiate from avocados based on the color of their rind. This one has a black rind. Florida avocados are actually bigger and have a green rind. Our next step is to add 2/3 of a cup of parsley. You can also use dried parsley if you don't have access to fresh herbs. The same with all of these herbs. They'll usually be dried and you can find them at your local supermarket as well. 2/3 of a cup of cilantro, 2/3 of a cup of mint, 6 sliced scallions. And our next step is adding 1 can of garbanzo beans or chickpeas, which equals 15 ounces. Our next step is to add 2 tablespoons of flour, and this can be any type of flour. Our next one is 1 teaspoon salt, preferably iodized, 1 teaspoon of freshly squeezed lemon or container lemon, either one. And then we're adding 2 cloves of garlic, and they're quite different sizes in garlic, so that's up to you and your preference. And then lastly, we need a pan, nonstick pan, but preferably have parchment paper on it as well. All right, so as with any recipe or anytime you cook, you really need to practice safe handling and sanitation skills. So what I'm going to begin doing is washing my hands for at least 30 seconds in as hot as water as you can possibly stand, just to kill the bacteria in it. So beginning with our baked falafel with avocado, I'm going to go ahead and start with putting our herbs in first. So again, this was 2/3 of a cup of parsley, 2/3 of a cup of cilantro, 2/3 of a cup of mint. We have some scallions in here, 6 scallions sliced. We have 1 can of garbanzo or chickpeas, same thing. We have 2 tablespoons of flour. All right. And then 1 teaspoon of salt. And again, you can always, with a lot of recipes, you can choose to add salt near the end. Because this is baked, it's easier just for everything, for the salt to be added at the beginning. But for a lot of these recipes, you can add salt to your likings at the end. And we have 2 cloves of garlic in here. So last, we just need to add the avocado. I had sliced 1/4 of an avocado here. I'm just gonna dice it. And if it's ripe, it should just easily slide off. Just gonna put this on. All right, so this is a food processor and it does have a pulsing mechanism. So just go ahead and pulse this a few times. If you have to open it up and kind of get the edges kind of scraped down, totally fine, you can do that. All right, kind of just scrape the edges down. Just that. Close it. Slice the garlic. garlic or anything that could be chunky, and the processor just misses, so really dice that garlic well. All right, so now that I have everything combined in the food processor for the falafel, I'm going to preheat the oven to 375 degrees. And while I'm letting that sit, we're gonna have to refrigerate these after we put them on the pan, because that is gonna help them bind together. So I'm just gonna do one. I have one tablespoon measuring spoon right here. And make sure your hands are washed again. So I'm just getting this out. This is one tablespoon. And here I have my nonstick pan. And I'm just gonna take this and see in my hand, I'm just gonna roll it up. And this should be a perfect size for a really nice falafel. So I'm just gonna press this down just a little bit and then put that on one. So we're gonna do the rest of this and put it in the fridge for about 1 to 3 hours. If not, totally fine. If you're in a rush, go ahead and as long as they're sticking pretty well together, you can shoot them in the oven as soon as it's preheated. Hi, we're back. So we've put in the fridge the falafel avocado mixture just to keep it cool and to help it bind together. So I'm gonna go grab the falafel. And this made about 21 falafels, so we're just gonna go ahead and put this in the oven that was preheated for 375 degrees. So we're gonna put this in here for exactly 22 minutes. So now that's in there for 22 minutes. After that timer is up, we're gonna take them out and then flip them for another 8 minutes in the oven. Right, so next we're gonna have our avocado hummus to put on top and on the side. So we're gonna start with 1 clove of garlic. We have 3 tablespoons of freshly squeezed lime or lemon. We have 1/4 teaspoon of cumin. We have 1.5 tablespoons of tahini. So make sure with tahini, it's gonna settle, naturally settle. So make sure you stir it before you allocate the amounts needed for this recipe. And again, that was 1 tablespoon and 1/2 tablespoon, so 1.5 tablespoons. Our next is 1 can or 15 ounces of garbanzo beans or chickpeas. Next is 3 tablespoons of olive oil. And then after that, there is 2 Haas avocados, average size. And again, these are California or Haas avocados. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the, we again have the food processor. And for the black pepper and salt, you can just season at the end for your preference. So you don't have to add a certain amount into the recipe. So I'm going to take these 2 Haas avocados into the food processor. We have our olive oil. Alright. Then we have 1 can of garbanzo beans. And I put this tissue just on the side just to reference to. Make sure your garbanzo beans are patted dry. You don't want the hummus too wet, so you want to make sure the chickpeas are dry for that. And then 1.5 tablespoons of our tahini. All right, our next was that 1/4 teaspoon of cumin. And avocados are so rich in monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats. These actually help lower your LDL and help reduce chronic diseases, especially the risk of heart disease. So it's a really good substitution, even for like salad dressings, anything that might require butter or any fatty source ingredient like that, avocados are great substitutions. And I'm just finishing off with our garlic over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and put our food processor on. All right, so our hummus is gonna require a smoother consistency than our falafel. So you wanna make sure it is pretty smooth. All right, so just like the falafel, even if we have to open it and then scoop the sides out, totally fine. Let's go ahead and get our spatula out of here. Replace. Make sure in between all of these recipes you wash your hands just because you might touch other things, other equipment. Just good to have our hands nice and clean for that. The Dietary Guidelines for Americans, edition 2015 to 2020, actually states that the top four nutrients of concern include potassium, vitamin D, calcium, and dietary fiber. Avocados are so rich in at least three of those four nutrients of concern, the top nutrients of concern, and those include potassium, which a Hass avocado actually provides 14% if you eat an average Hass avocado. For calcium, it actually provides about 2% for the day, and for dietary fiber, it provides at least 36%, at least for a California avocado, which is smaller than a Florida avocado. So if you do eat a Florida avocado, you'll get that and more, just because the nutrients are going to be more in a bigger avocado. So today I just scooped out the avocado hummus into a bowl, and then on the side you can actually season it as you like with salt and pepper, which another thing, avocados are very low in sugar and salt, which is great for diabetics, pre-diabetics, or those with high blood pressure and other chronic diseases where that really plays a big role. And also I have some herbs here. I just have cilantro, that's my favorite, but you can have parsley, mint, or cilantro if you're liking. So I went ahead and seasoned that. And then once the falafel is ready, we're gonna pull that out and then begin with our dark chocolate avocado mousse smoothie. All right, so I pulled the falafel, avocado falafel, out of the oven after 22 minutes at 375 degrees. So here's what they look like after being flipped. So they're nice and golden brown. So when I said earlier, you can either put this on parchment paper or just a nonstick pan is fine. You don't even have to grease them. So I flipped the falafel, and then now we're gonna actually put this back in the oven at 375 still for 8 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Like I said, put this on for 8 minutes. Right. All right, so right down here after the 8 minutes back in the oven at 375 degrees, we took them out. These falafels are done, so now they're just sitting, getting cooled. I'm gonna actually start the dark chocolate avocado mousse smoothie now. Right, so first off, we actually have two bananas that were previously frozen. So a good technique to do for this is not put the entire banana in the freezer. You're gonna have trouble peeling it. So make sure you unpeel the banana, slice them, and then put them and freeze them. I usually use parchment paper or something that's nonstick. So then after that, you can easily take them off the parchment paper. So these are two frozen bananas. I'm just gonna slip into the blender right here. All right, our next ingredient is 1 cup of spinach. And make sure you slice the spinach. If you don't have a super high powered blender, it might have trouble slicing and combining the spinach. So just make sure you slice it too, just so it's easier on the food processor or the blender. Put that over here. All right, so we also have 2 tablespoons of honey. Of course, depending on how your sweetness preference is, 2 bananas might be sweet enough for you, but I like to add a little bit of honey as well. So this is 2 tablespoons. And you also might have to I get this off the edge. Alrighty, so that is 2 tablespoons of honey in there. Next off, I have 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. I have 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder. Right, and then I have 1 cup of soy milk, but you can do any milk. I usually like to use like vitamin D fortified. That's gonna help get those nutrients of concern knocked out for your day. And this is 1 cup, so you can use whatever milk you would want to use. Alright, so lastly, I have 1 entire Haas avocado pitted and peeled. Alright, so because avocados are so rich in fatty acids, these fats actually help absorb fat-soluble vitamins like A, D, E, and K. So naturally, avocados have C, E, and K vitamins in them, which are great antioxidants for your day. They also have micronutrients such as minerals like copper, magnesium, and zinc. So these are great sources as well. So I already have my ingredients in the blender. I'm gonna go ahead and at full speed, go ahead and blend it. Leftover ingredients on the side, just go ahead and take a spatula and kind of scoop that out and back into it. All right, so I have my spatula, and like I said, I'm just going to scoop the rest of those sides off and back into it. A lot of times the powder of like the cocoa powder or cinnamon gets on the side, so you just want to make sure it's all blended. Alrighty, so I have that. Right, so now that we have all of our ingredients blended in, I just wanted to add 1 cup of ice. And of course, to your liking, of course the bananas were frozen, so if you want it cooler, go ahead and put 1 cup of ice in there. And I'm just gonna blend this again. Okay, lock it. Alrighty, so we're back and we have finished all of our recipes. I took the falafels out of the oven and let them cool for like 10 to 20 minutes. And we have our avocado hummus. So I'm just gonna take these falafels off and then show, right, and then 2 more in this. And again, these made 21 falafels. That's quite a bit. Right, so I'm just gonna go ahead and scoop this avocado hummus. You can go ahead and just put them on top. And then I only did 3 for you guys just to see. But here they are. Right, nice and green and colorful. So now I'm gonna move on to our dark chocolate mousse smoothie. You guys check that out. And this smoothie actually makes about 2 servings too.